Hello, I'm Grace Farrell. This is the 86th Floor, and these are six great things that happened because of Star Wars that aren't Star Wars. Number 1, CGI characters. When George Lucas began work on Star Wars in 1975, he felt that the special effects on offer at 20th Century Fox weren't really up to scratch, so he created his own visual effects company, Industrial Light & Magic. This became the powerhouse for the special effects boom of the 80s and 90s, and was responsible for the first ever totally computer-generated sequence. The first CGI photorealistic character, and the first detailed morphing sequence.
Looks good. Luwapa Danu. Tuwapa Tuwapa. Look for Danalora. Look for Danalora. Luwapa Danu. Tuwapa Danu. Look for Danalora. Luwapa Danu. Tuwapa Tuwapa. Skank Danu. Look for Danalora. Luwapa Danu.
ILM gave us many of our best-loved CGI characters, including Casper, Drago and Flubber, as well as less-loved characters like the T-1000, Davy Jones and Voldemort. Number 2, it marked the wide-scale introduction of Dolby Stereo. At the time of release, the newer 4-channel system was only available in certain cinemas, but the success of Star Wars in 1977 inspired owners of smaller movie theatres to install stereo equipment for the first time, thus creating a much better listening experience.
And this is my counterpart, R2-D2.
Hello.
Number 3, summer blockbusters. Although Jaws was the first movie to really flourish at the box office in what was traditionally a quiet season, Star Wars smashed the record and solidified the trend. In the decade that followed, almost all the biggest blockbusters of the year were released in the summer months. Number 4, Indiana Jones, obviously. Number 5, awesome merch. Before Star Wars came out, merchandise was just a bit, well, crap. And it didn't tie into movie releases very well. But Lucas saw the money to be made through good merchandising and bought the licensing rights to the Star Wars franchise. Star Wars toys were the must-have item on every kid's wish list in the 70s and 80s, especially the original 1970s action figures. And who could forget the seething jealousy that every British kid felt towards the lucky Americans who got to wear the Luke Skywalker X-Wing pilot uniform? They just never had them in the shops over here. We're still not over it. And at number 6, it's Pixar. Yes, Pixar started life as a subdivision of Lucas's special effects studio, ILM, in 1979. It was later bought by Steve Jobs and went on to give us some of our fondest animated titles, including Toy Story, Finding Nemo, and Up. Thanks a bunch, George Lucas. We really do owe you one. And don't forget, Star Wars The Force Awakens hits cinemas in mid-December.